Hey, what's up guys? It's Brian here, Brian's All Maintenance. All right, we're doing another FAQ today, frequently asked question. These ones are all submitted by you guys. And this one was buying versus leasing of lawnmowers. This is gonna be a juicy one. Stay tuned, let's check it out. Hey, what's up guys? My name is Brian here. And you know what? I've been doing a frequently asked question video series here with you guys, trying to mix these videos in, going through spring to help you guys out with common questions that you guys have with going into the lawn care landscaping industry. The one I wanted to talk about today was buying mowers versus leasing mowers. I think it's a really good topic and conversation. And in fact, I have never leased a lawnmower, so I'd love to hear your guys' thoughts if you guys do the leasing program or the new every two, they call it, right? A lot of companies and brands offer that and dealers offer that. Let's go into the thought process and the discussion. I'm gonna try to answer this one in 5 minutes or less. And by the time we're done, hit the like on the video if you enjoy it, and definitely leave me a comment down below, participate in the conversation, because I think it's gonna be a really good one. When it comes to lawn care, obviously the lawnmower is going to be our staple piece of equipment that is going to be our bread and butter to get the work done. But as you would also imagine, it's going to be the piece of equipment that accumulates the most amount of wear and tear, accumulates the most amount of hours, and of course is going to be probably most subject to breakdowns, right? So there is a philosophy or concept out there where you can new every two a mower. You can trade them in for the newest technology, the newest equipment, the newest upgrades. And by the way, just like a car vehicle, not have to deal with breakdowns or maintenance, some of this stuff is all inclusive, which is good. And some folks really, really like that. There's some parts and perks to having a leasing program where if your mower happens to break down, you'll automatically get a loaner or a demo mower to, you know, get you at least right back out the door so you can keep working. All which really, really makes sense, especially for an owner-operator. The other side of the coin is financing a mower or purchasing a mower outright. I think there is absolutely some merit to that as well. So it's kind of like this balancing act, if you will, where just like when you buy a car, at the end of paying it off, you own it. And that is an awesome thing for a few years after the fact, that once you pay it off, whether it's brand new or after a 4 or 5 year note, whether it's a car or a mower, right? But then, as you guys would know, and I just did a video not too long about this, was when it comes the time to trade in that mower, when it starts turning into a hassle or a headache because of maintenance and repair bills. Now again, if you're really handy and hands-on and mechanically inclined, which I always encourage that skill set because it's gonna be one of the largest costs to your business, which is downtime and maintenance work and going to your dealer. So if you can save money there, you're gonna be in really good shape, especially long-term. But working on your own equipment can also be a huge roadblock for a lot of folks. Like, I'm not super mechanically inclined, so I also really understand and appreciate the idea of having a lease option. Now, in full disclosure, I've never leased a mower. I've never done the new every two. I also know that they can break up the payments where it's 7 months of payments on and then 5 months where you don't make payments because it's the off season. But obviously you have a ballooned payment during the 7 months of the active season. So if your mower is 250 bucks a month, let's say, you might be paying 350 for that privilege. But you know what? Here's another part. It's a fixed cost. When you have a mower that you bought and you purchased on your own, you might have a couple months where there's no cost and no maintenance to it, other than the initial purchase. But then outside of that, you might have a month or two where you get just slammed with an $800 repair bill because you blow a head gasket, a spindle goes out, something crazy, a hydro pump, and it's 1500 bucks, right? Just, you know, worst case scenario type things. I'm kind of curious to know what you guys do. For me personally, I'm starting to lean more like towards the middle of this whole discussion. If you would have caught me 2 or 3 years ago, I would have been far right with talking about buying a mower outright, paying cash, or even financing it. I couldn't care less. But at the same point, owning the piece of equipment after it's paid for, right? But then it always seems to be the fact that once you get to about 1500 hours, you usually pay off the mower, and the mower starts breaking down. So it's almost like, if I know that this is a fixed cost anyway, and I get depreciation and I can still get the tax benefits, and it's a new every two or a new every three or whatever your dealer offers and your brand offers, then this also is kind of a enticing option. Again, this is a video where not only do you guys learn from me, sort of, I get to learn from you guys. And you know, the best part is we can all read the comments down below. Let me know if you guys are a purchase, finance, own kind of mindset, or if you guys are a lease and do new every two. I'll tell you guys straight up, where I live, there is a handful of companies that they overwhelmingly love the lease program. And I'm curious if that's more of a commercial, like a larger company decision, or if they're just finding some extra benefits with having new technology, mowers that aren't breaking down, so on and so forth. There's one company right down the road from where I live. They finance, or I should say lease, they lease 26 mowers a year, every other year, and they just trade them back in, and they just always have brand new shiny mowers, and they're always, you know, killing it, crushing it, and there's very minimal downtime, right? So anyway, let me know what you guys think. Finance or lease, new every two, what do you guys think about that? Kind of curious, especially if you're just getting started in business. It is kind of nice to, you know, keep some of your cash reserves in hand, lease something, always know that it's gonna be there for you, have no downtime. And like I said, catch me 2-3 years ago, I would have been finance or bust. Now where I'm at, I'm kind of in the middle of that spectrum. So let me know what you guys think. Love to hear that thought. Guys, if you're new, check out the rest of the frequently asked question playlist. There's some really good videos in there. If not, we'll catch you guys on one of the other videos to have some fun on. Don't forget to subscribe, and guys, we'll see you soon.